Okay, my friend called me over to work on his oven. I obviously don't work on ovens every day. It was displaying an error code. I'll put in a picture of it. It said FE08 oven speed fan too low. So he went ahead and ordered two different fans. There's one that is inside the oven back there in a box. And then there's another fan, according to the internet, that's somewhere right here. So to start, we just pulled all of the eyes off the oven. They just pull out, then it leaves you two screws. You're gonna undo all of those screws on all the burners. And then as far as the knobs go, you can legitimately just pull them straight up. So you'll just pull it straight up and it comes off of there. One thing I do wanna mention is that this oven is gas and electric. So you wanna find the gas knob and turn it off and just go ahead and unplug it from the wall. Or go find the breaker and trip it off. That way you can't accidentally electrocute yourself or blow yourself up, either way. After all the screws are out of the top of the oven, there's gonna be three that you'll get on the bottom of the oven. Here, here, and then way over there. So I'll go ahead and take these off and then get back with you guys. Also, when you're ordering parts, you wanna pay attention to the model number of the oven, which is on a sticker right there. And that's how you order parts. When you take the last screw out, it's gonna expose all of this here, and this cover is gonna come down, so don't freak out when the cover comes down. On the back of the oven, there are three screw holes there, there, and there. I've already taken them off, so you'll slide this cover back, flip it up and out of the way, and you can already see what appears to be a vent or an intake for some fan. Which is what we think the problem is. After that, there are two screws on either end under these tabs, there and there. I've already removed those as well. And then the popping noise, that's fine. Yeah, it's totally fine. Okay, so now this is hard to do with one hand, so I'm gonna let go and then come back to you guys. This can now come up as seen here, but we had to figure out how to get this end up. And I believe the only thing that's holding this top oven in is this support right here where it screws in. So I think if you undo this screw here, and then on the other side, there's another screw right there. If we undo those two screws, this should pop off as well. But you wanna be mindful that there are plugs going to it. Let's see if there's a disconnect that we can do before we get everything undone. No, it doesn't work, I can get to it. Here we go. Plug, just simply, it's hard to see.
Okay, the two screws were definitely what was holding this on because now it moves pretty freely.
By the way, a pro tip, if you can figure out how to take the door off the oven, it'd probably be a lot easier to work around. Get down here. So that just slides forward. And you wanna be real slow and careful because there are gas lines and everything else. There we go. And then there is the ribbon cable. And
okay, so it's got the same thing. It's just got the little tab that you'll move with your thumb and then it comes out. Now it looks like it's got cardboard over it and you might be tempted to remove it because the way that it's screwed in and the way that it looks makes me think it's some type of temperature resistant material to help protect that circuit board up under there. So I would leave that exactly where it is. The good news is this is idiot proof. You can't put either plug in the wrong way and you can't put them in the wrong hole. So that's good to know. With that out of the way, I can see the only two things holding the cooktop on are gonna be the screw here, one screw here, and one screw there. So we'll take those three off. We should be able to get this off, and then the fan should be somewhere around here. Okay, we've got it where I can see a little piece of a motor right here, and there's a lot of different things that want to keep this down. So like I said, first of all, and most importantly, we have turned the knob off to the gas line. So that's most important. Second most important thing is that these fittings probably have some type of thread tape in there.
and I don't wanna undo them. I don't think you should undo them either. So what I'm gonna try to do is just undo the Phillips head screwdrivers that are holding all these burners down. There's just little clips that hold these wires into place. Should be really easy to just squeeze together. Yep, hard to do that with my raccoon finger. I was bitten by a raccoon a couple weeks ago. Still healing. So we'll take these clips off, put them out of the way for later. Now we should just be able to, this is a one piece unit from here all the way to there. So if we undo screw here, screw here, it's missing one from there, missing one from there. So it probably doesn't get one. This is the first time this oven has been apart to my knowledge. That screw there, and then all the burners, we can move these lines out of the way, but not too aggressively. And we should be able to pick this tray up and slide it backwards. That is my theory. And we may wind up having to unhook these sparks here, the things that make the spark, basically a spark plug. Okay, that was much easier than thought. I did this with my fingers. You pull this slot out, and then you should be able to pick up and put it back down. Now in a scenario like this, I would tell you to label them, but I don't think that you'll be able to do them wrong. I say that, someone out there will do this wrong. So if you want, it'd be a good time to take some tape or something and wrap around it so you could say, you know, bottom left eye, top right eye before you undo all of these. Anyways, but that's all it takes to undo it. Just pull the pin out, pull it up, and then it'll come out. Pretty simple. All right, all of those are undone. This is an open slot, so we can just take these and drape them over the back, and now we'll undo these with our Phillips head screwdriver. All right, all the eyes are loose. The screws are out of here and over there. There's one screw. Looks like this may be an inlet duct for this fan, and then maybe that's the exhaust over there. I'm not sure. But now we'll slowly try to, yep, that was nice and slow. We'll pick it up and move it back. What we don't wanna do is nick any of these lines, because there is, like I said, gas going through it, so you wanna be nice and slow. So I can see right now it's sticking on this line. So I'll just gently move it up, and boom, that's out of the way. It's gonna stick on this line, so we'll do the same thing here. We'll just gently go up. Anything else that might stick right here, we'll gently move that one up just a hair. You don't wanna move anything more than you have to on a project like this. So see, it's sticking here, so move it up. Sticking on that one there. That one's out of the way now. Now we're sticking here on the inside. And like I said, I'm holding the phone with one hand and doing this with the other hand. And this is the first time I've ever done this. So it's really not that difficult of a job. Don't let yourself think that it is. Boom, that's undone. We'll set this out of the way. Looks like maybe something got through here and spilled. Something to note, there's a really big circuit board right here, and everything on it looks okay. Nothing looks crazy burnt. I would check there. But most importantly, we are here for this fan. Double check. Yep, it's unplugged. Notice that's not a standard plug. That's a 240 volt plug, so you wanna make sure you unplug it. Nothing here is that hard, but you can make it harder by not unplugging it and shocking yourself. So now we're gonna take this fan apart, and it really appears that this is the only screw holding this fan in, and it's barely engaged at the present moment. So this should be easy. I'm not even gonna turn the camera off. All right, we're rolling live. Let's see if you can see it right there. All right, just gonna let that sit there. Notice there are a few plugs going into this. Let's see. I'm not gonna unplug them just yet. Yeah, so you'll pull the motor back. Sorry, I got a trick finger. There we go. All right, we've got the fan out. Notice it's got a rubber surround. I'm gonna try to save that. It's gonna be hard to film and do with one hand, but we'll give it a shot. We've got a plug here. Looks like we just lift on the edges, and this is carrying current to the motor. I'm gonna have to use my other hand, sorry. So that plug is out. We'll notice that it is an idiot-proof plug. Then we have got another smaller plug right here. I say this is idiot-proof because it's impossible to install it the wrong way. I say impossible, it's like I said before, there's always a way for someone who's willing to push hard enough. And then this plug, let me get it out of there as well. All right, so that is all unhooked. And well, ladies here, definitely tell. This is the duct that that fan sits over. I was reading on some forums just now where some people were saying that this motor was for the top of the oven only to cool off this circuit board. And it looks like there's an opening on the fan that it would cool off some here, but it is definitely pushing air down there. And when you shine a flashlight, you can see that it goes all the way around the bottom side of the oven. So while the oven's cooking, it's trying to cool off everything under there or circulate hot air evenly throughout the inside of the oven. So I would say that, you know, both of these fans are pretty important. And that looks like a gouge, but it's not. It is a Sharpie mark that I just noticed and thought it was a hole and freaked out. But there is a saving grace if you do have a hole. All right, guys, so I freaked out a little bit at first because there's the fan right there. The fan is there. I don't have a flashlight on me. I'll try to take a picture, but it's spinning right now. It didn't start spinning until it got over, I think it was 175. Let's see if you can hear it. Right there. So that gray blur, that's actually the fan spinning, and I can feel the air coming off of it. What I don't know is if you have to have that top plate cover on to direct the flow of air or not. I'm not sure, but that flow of air goes right over this circuit board and probably helps keep things cool. I'm testing it like this, so a lot of you might be asking, can I just leave this on instead of taking the burners off? Just leave this piece on. You can't. You have to take this off because there are three screws that go into the burner there. So I thought that as well, but just to save you some time, no, you have to take this off. I just have it sitting up there right now. The valves to the gas lines kind of hold it in place. It's not even screwed in, but I do have the wires plugged up, and that is turning really nicely, really fast, whereas before it was not. So I'm feeling pretty confident in the repair. We're at 235 degrees. As you can see, it is 12:06 p.m. So we're gonna let this get to 350, and I will come back periodically to check on it. I may go ahead and take the cover and just set it up here in case it does have something to do with cooling. I'm not gonna screw it down, but I'll update you guys as we go along. Just a quick update. It is 12:23. It's 12:23. It's like 7 o'clock, but it's been on since 12:06. I think we started it, and I said 350. It got to operating temp probably 5 minutes ago, and it's holding it. I can hear that fan running down there. I can feel some of the air coming out of these holes, so I guess that's a good way to check after you put this cover on. Anyways, test seems to be going well, so we're gonna run it for 30 more minutes, and if it keeps temp, then we're gonna call it good. But before, what they said it was doing is the oven wouldn't even turn on for like 5 minutes. He'd been unplugging it and replugging it, but the problem kept getting worse and worse. So I think it was just the motor and that fan was going bad. All right, folks, the oven has been off for quite a few minutes. And if you listen, you can still hear the fan running. So the oven, I mean, obviously you can still touch the top because the inner oven was on, but this is warm. So those fans must keep circulating air until the oven is cooled down to a specific temperature, and then it'll turn off. So all I'm gonna do now is take this back off, put the little spark things back in there, and call it a day. Hopefully this video has helped you guys out. If you could hit that like and subscribe button, leave me a comment below. If you have a question that's relatively easy, I'll try to answer it for you. But if I don't know, I just don't know. This is the only time I've ever done it, but it's definitely, that old fan was bad. Peace out.